So today we're going to take a look at Chem110's Lab C, which is the oxygen content lab, and we're just going to do a quick rundown of what you should expect to be doing procedurally wise for this lab, and what setups you should expect to be able to produce. So we're going to start off by clamping a balloon using a spring clamp. So as you can see here, it works a little bit better with two people. You can do it by yourself, but with two people it just makes things go a little bit smoother. Next, we're going to move on to setting up our detergent beakers as well as our vinegar beaker. So as you can see here, we have two beakers out, both of which are going to be set up with our detergent mixture. And this is what our syringes are going to be sitting in once we have our steel wool inside of them. And then that third beaker there, we're going to fill up with our vinegar solution, which has been prepped for you already. So with the procedures, you're going to want to use the values that are given to you in the lab procedures instead of just estimating like this. But for the purpose of this procedure, we'll go ahead and just estimate. And then you're going to want to add your NaCl into the vinegar, and so a few scoops should be fine. And you're going to mix that in until you don't see any or very few clumps of NaCl floating around in your solution. Next, we're going to take the mass of our steel wool ball, and you're going to want to take the mass and you're going to want to record that for your post-lab calculations later on. So while that's soaking, we're going to go ahead and start setting up the rest of our lab prep. So to do so, we're going to pull apart our syringe and we're going to remove the plunger. And then we're going to take our three-prong clamp and we're going to set that up onto a ring stand. And this is just a little time save, a little tip or trick that you can use. So once it's been sitting for about a minute, you're just going to want to make sure that, again, all your steel wool has been soaked into your solution. And then you're going to want to take it over to the sink, where you're going to want to make sure you shake off all of your excess solution. And this is just to make sure that all your steel wool that has been soaked just doesn't have any residual solution left over. That way you get the most out of your reaction in the syringe. Then we're going to take our steel wool and push it down into the syringe between about the 10 milliliter and 30 milliliter mark. Somewhere in between there should be fine, it doesn't have to be exact. And then we're going to take the tip of our plunger and we're going to insert that back into the main body and push it down to about the 28.5 or the 28 milliliter mark. Again, it doesn't have to be exact. And then we're going to secure that into our three-prong clamp. And then we're going to soak the tip of the syringe into our detergent solution. And that should be the setup that you should expect to have once you have your syringes set. The second portion of this lab is almost identical procedurally to the first. The only difference is that we're going to be filling our second syringe with the air from the balloon. The trick to this is you're going to want to make sure that the plunger isn't blocking the hole that's been drilled into the syringe at the very top. This is going to allow the air to flow from the tip of the syringe out through the top of the syringe, and it's going to make sure that any residual air that's been inside the syringe is pushed out by the air in the balloon. And that should be the setup that your second syringe should look like. And then once you've successfully set up both of your syringes, this is what your complete lab setup should look like.